Hey bosses, welcome back to my channel for today's video. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys step-by-step how to build your online boutique's website. Thank you to Wix for sponsoring today's video. This video is made in paid collaboration with Wix. So if you've been struggling with your store or you just need some advice on how to upgrade the look of your store, let's go ahead and get into making our online websites and I will see you all in the back end of Wix. So today we're going to be making a clothing boutique website. When you come here, they have 80 plus customizable templates. Like, and when I say template, I mean it pretty much is already built for you. It's up to you to determine what you want your store to look like beforehand, y'all, because there's so many options. And the good thing about it is you can really actually click on any of these and view them as a demo, like as a full functioning website without having to actually choose it first. So let's view this one. You know what? I like this one. Now, once you're here, whatever you want to change, just click on it and you can edit it. So when you click on it, you'll get some different options. The first thing I'm going to do is change my picture. Okay, so I'm adding my pictures now to my site. You guys can see that I'm uploading 22 pictures. So when adding pictures to add to your homepage, it's important that you're adding pictures that really define your brand. So if your brand, like my brand, is bold, bright, fun. So the pictures that you see right here are bold, they're bright, they're fun. I'm gonna make sure that the images that I add in the beginning are really gonna catch my audience attention and they define my brand. So I really like this one. Yes, honey. Okay, I like this. I'm gonna like kind of crop this a little bit so make sure it's fit in the right place. Now, of course, the colors here are not matching, so I can just click on this and now I can change the design. And there's different colors. We can do white, we can do black. For now, I'm gonna leave it white because I really want like a clean, crisp, modern website. So I changed it up just a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna play around with the colors some more, but one thing that I noticed is that this strip has a different background, so I'm gonna change this to white. I don't want too many colors, especially because my colors are on my clothing. So I went ahead and just changed everything to white. I think that looks best with this pop of color. And so now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna change up the font a little bit. As you're building a brand, you wanna have brand recognition, and you can do that when you use the same fonts, colors, and the look all over. So with your website, keep that in mind. You don't wanna have too many fonts. You should have like maximum of 2 different fonts on your website. So go through these. They have so many options already in here. Now, another thing I like about Wix is when you're doing this, you can always press preview to see like, okay, like what is it looking like so far? How is my site coming together when I first come? And here it is. I love it. What about y'all? Okay, now this, what's going on here? Y'all see that? Let's fix this. Let's get into some of our products. So to start adding your own products, you can just click here and click on manage products. And now we're gonna go into our Wix dashboard. What I would suggest to make it easy for you is to just click on a pre-existing product and just edit it to match what your product actually is. Let's look at this. Collections are extremely important. We can see these different collections. So this is what this is talking about. And so if I keep it how it is, this is gonna show up under accessories, and this is not an accessory. Determine what collections you wanna have in your store. So do you wanna have collections like women's, men's, kids, or collections like outerwear, tops, bottoms, jumpsuits? I like working in the second category of like outerwear and things like that. So I'm gonna start creating some collections here. I'm gonna name this one outerwear. Make sure you are very clearly defining about the product. I give a short description, just talking about where my audience can see themselves wearing this item. And then I also then give the true details, the hard facts, comfortable fit, true to size. You have to always say that if it is or if it's not. Give some details and always talk about the material of whatever you're selling. So we need to go ahead and add our variants. So here a variant is like size, color. And I'm gonna do size, and I'm just gonna add in the different options for this jacket. Make sure you put it in order. This is how it's gonna show up on the product page. I do want to track my inventory. This is how you can make sure that you don't oversell, to make sure that you only sell what you have. So you wanna track your inventory yourself, and I have about 2 of each item. I'm just gonna put that here. You also want to add the weight. I suggest that you add the weight of your items immediately, and that's because when we get to shipping, I'm gonna be doing you and showing you how to do weight-based shipping. In order for that to work, you have to already know what the weight of the item is. So we just added our first product to our site. We're gonna go ahead and save this, and let's see how we can get this on our homepage. I wanna see that first product on my page. So in order to actually edit what we see here physically, just double tap. And now we can connect this to a different item, which is my item. And woo, we have our first picture, our first product on our site. But I will add some things. So I'm gonna go down to the store. Instead of just having one product, I wanna have a grid. So before we just had a product widget, I'm gonna add a grid. Manage this by just double clicking this, and we're gonna make this a lot smaller by looking at the layout. So I only wanna have 3 pictures in a row, and I only wanna have like 1 or 2 rows, really just 1. Because there is a view more button. On my own, added in some more product. I added in some products, and I want to show you guys some different ways to edit your collections. We're going to change the font of this, don't worry, but here I named this New Arrivals, and here I literally just have my new arrivals. So when you click on this, double click it actually, you can control what products show up here under the collection tab. So I showed you guys how I create new collections and how I put the items in those collections. And so of course we have the ones that they made, accessories, and men. I made a new arrival one, outerwear, and then I also made a set one because I have a lot of sets. These are all sets. And so I'm going to show you now how I can, like, you can either just create collections right here or click on manage collections. And this is where you're going to be able to, even after the fact, add new collections, place items inside of your collections, and control what shows up where. So if you don't, like, I don't want any of these ones, I'm gonna delete the ones that they gave me because it just doesn't apply to my store right now. When you click on a collection, like let's say I wanna edit my new arrivals, you can easily just either delete products out of it or add products. Okay, and so I added, like, you know, 5 products to my store, and so of course you'll add all your products that you have, and so I'm gonna go ahead and add those ones back. And also you can rearrange the order of them because this is gonna matter based on how you want it to show up on your website. Okay, and let's say you wanna add another collection to your site. Let's say that you have your new arrivals, maybe you wanna showcase like all of your lounge pieces, or you wanna showcase all of your sale items. You can just go back the same way that we did the first time. You can click on add, we're down at store, and you can either add another gallery, you can add a slider, which is pretty cool. Slider this time, and I'm gonna make sure that whatever collection I decide to use is gonna be a collection that's not already existing, like showing things that are already on my site. Like, you don't wanna double show products, right? You wanna give them enough things to look at. So I'm gonna, again, double click, and collection, I wanna choose my sale items. So I'm gonna also change the layout to maybe just show 3 items or 3 columns, and it has to slide over in order for them to see more. But let's look so far what we have, and they can slide. I like to continually remind my audience of like what my brand is about. So I'm gonna add just a slight, maybe like a quote right here about boldness. Remember, my brand is boldness. I'm gonna use a quote about boldness. I'm just gonna add in, you can add in a strip, but we really can just add text to the screen, honestly. because I'm happy with how this looks, I'm actually gonna delete this and just have it just like so. So we already have our sale page, but we need a page for everything else. This is where I can actually do my store, and I wanna go to store pages and I wanna add a store page. Now it's gonna automatically create the page over here. We're gonna edit this because remember we want it to show up underneath the category, not within its own page. Automatically, it's going to list all of our products. Now we do need a shop all, so we're gonna actually leave this like such, and I'm gonna have to actually create a different page for every category that I want to show off. I'm gonna double click and name this shop all, and I'm gonna actually drag this up underneath the category. Let's see how our work has come together. So we have shop by category, and I just want to shop all to see everything you have in your store, and boom, there it is. Look at how clear that was to put together. So now that we have our website how we want, the most important thing, you all, is to edit your mobile site. Most of your visitors are going to be coming off of their mobile device, so you definitely want to edit and make sure your site also looks good on mobile. But let's get into the actual editing part of this. I actually like how this looks, but just make sure like everything is just placed how it needs to. Usually you just have to come through and do like just tiny edits to make sure everything is how you want it. I'm lost in the night. We can do my life. Light is always a kiss before day. When you arrive, you came alongside to take me away. So things like this, you definitely want to change. So just hit this arrow and it'll go right in the right place. And now we can finish the rest of the setup process. We got the best part out of the way. And look, we have a really good deal, you guys. A lot of times they have great deals. You can come on and get these premium packages, which I would suggest that you do get a premium package, and we'll talk about why in a second. But first, let's get our shipping policy together. And so here we wanna click on setup shipping regions. And it's really cool because they have like your setup steps right here. And you really wanna go through and get all these steps completed. You can offer international shipping if you so wish. I don't offer it at the time, so I'm gonna make it true to myself. And I'm gonna go ahead and edit the shipping rules because right now it's gonna give all your customers free shipping. That is nice, but that's not what we're gonna do today. So let's edit our shipping rule. And I'm gonna do it based on weight. Remember, we added our weight of our product, so we're gonna also do weight-based shipping. I think that my policy is gonna be 3 to 5 business days as well. And so here is where we're gonna set up the actual terms. So if it's less than a pound and up to a pound, I charge my customers $5. You can decide how much you wanna charge them based on how much shipping costs in your area. And then I know that if it's gonna be 1 pound or higher, I'm gonna charge them $8. What I also love to do is I'm gonna offer them free shipping when they spend a certain amount. Let's say if they spend $100, they get awarded free shipping. And boom, shipping is set up just that quick. Let's add some things to our cart and let's see what it tells us. Okay, I want a small jacket. And let's view our cart. You want to take yourself through this process to make sure that everything's going to work well. Remember that I put in this jacket is 1.2 pounds, so they're going to automatically charge my customer the amount for that higher weight shipping. If I add 2 of these, it's now going to offer them free shipping because I set the rule that if it's over $100, they get free shipping. So let's go back and let's actually finish up the setup process. Wix has so many different payment options. I was actually surprised to see all of the different options they offer. So you can definitely use Wix Payments. Wix Payments is like their signature credit card and debit card processor, which is great to have so that customers can just simply add their credit card number and check out on your site. You can also choose from so many different options of different services. You guys can look up to see which ones you want to offer in your store. These are the ones I like to add in my store. So I'm going to to go ahead and connect me. Now, we need to go ahead and, because right now, if someone bought something on our store, we would not get paid. You cannot get paid until you actually set up your plan. And so I know that I need e-commerce, so I'm gonna stay on this section. And they offer different ones, and it's important that you choose the right one for you. But it looks like the Business Unlimited has everything I need, so I'm gonna go ahead and go with the Business Unlimited plan. So I went ahead and upgraded my site, and look, I actually get to get my domain for free. So I can really just come in here and type in what I believe I want my domain to be. Now, every domain is not always available. Like this one is taken, but they will give you some other options. And so Fearless Boutique was taken, Shop Fearless was taken. So I put in fearlessshopboutique.com. So I'm gonna go ahead and claim that name, and I'm gonna go ahead and get it. And remember, because I chose the yearly plan, I actually get a free domain for the year. So the last step is to get seen by your customers. Wix literally has, you guys, every single tool that you need at your fingertips to get seen online. Right here in your marketing home, you have the tools to get found on Google. You have ways to get your ads on Facebook. Also, all the email marketing that you need is literally here in the marketing home section of Wix. And so I want you all to stay tuned, because in part two, I'm gonna be walking you guys through step by step what you should be doing right now to get more eyes on your site and more customers in your business, you guys. So if you guys are excited to learn more about how to market, how to take your Wix website even further, make sure you guys hit the link down below to start building your Wix website. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, bosses.